this is Roberta Glass. Today we're in court with NXIVM cult president Nancy Salzman. Pleads guilty and cries. Stay tuned. So this was a different kind of hearing than I had attended before for NXIVM. One, there were five lawyers for the prosecution, and there were only two lawyers and one defendant. Nancy Salzman, with her two lawyers, came to court today to plead guilty. And after we got through what seemed like a very long list of required questions that Judge Garifas asked her. One question was, had she had any alcohol or drugs? She said she had a glass of wine. Was she happy with her lawyers? Yes. Did anyone threaten her to plead guilty today? No. How old is she? 63. Where was she born? Newark, New Jersey. Where did she go to school? What kind of degree does she have? She has an associate's degree. She's a nurse. We heard a lot of those kinds of answers before she stood up and made her statement. But before I go into what she said when she pled guilty, I want to say that this is a Nancy Salzman I had not seen before. This was a more vulnerable, weepy, weak Nancy Salzman. This was not the kind of strong, poker-faced, tough Nancy Salzman I had seen in court before. This was a smaller, more feminine, and it almost seemed not flirting, but it is a kind of thing that at least I know I put on when I want my boyfriend to open a pickle jar. Like, honey, I'm such a weak female. Could you please open this for me type of voice? So that kind of voice, a very, she was using really soft voice and answering questions. The judge had to keep reminding her to verbalize. Instead, when she was asked how many glasses of wine she had, she put up her finger. You know, very feminine, put up a finger. And he had to say, one, you had one. So there was that going on. And there was many members of the press in attendance. So when it came time for her speech, you could hear the press scoot up, ears perk up, and we watched as Nancy Salzman wept so hard she was wiping her nose with her fist. And here's what she had to say. I am pleading today because I am in fact guilty. I've done a lot of soul searching over the past couple of months. When I joined or started NXIVM, I felt that what I was doing was helping people, and I still feel that NXIVM did some good. However, over time, my principles were compromised, and I hurt my daughters and my parents, and I also hurt others. But she didn't go into detail as to how. Then she went into detail, and she had to, about the two charges that she was pleading guilty to. One was identity theft and the other was conspiracy to alter records in a criminal proceeding. So she described hacking into the computers of NXIVM critics and using their email passwords to keep tabs on what they were doing, particularly NXIVM critics who were speaking out against NXIVM or were in litigation with NXIVM. And the second crime that she described was taking a videotape of her teaching the NXIVM classes that had to be handed over in discovery in a court case in New Jersey, and she did not want those certain sections of that videotape of her teaching the NXIVM class to be revealed, so she just edited out certain portions. The judge was incredibly nice to her. He said, "I know this is difficult for you." They talked about the sentencing. Now, the max sentencing that she could get is 20 years. The prosecution has modified her. You get a number of, it's her original number was 19. The prosecution added a couple points for what they called her aggravating role. So they enhanced it a couple points. Then they took away a couple points because she was owning up to her crimes and pleading guilty. So they ended up with the number 20. So the judge said that the probable sentence could be anywhere from 33 to 41 months in prison. And that was quite shocking to me. I don't know if it was so shocking that it was low or high, or that she was, that a 63-year-old woman was going to prison that I was looking at. I don't know. I was a little bit shocked by that. The judge said that he would take into consideration any letters that she had from her friends or family, and he looked at her and he said, "I know you've done some good in your life." Now, I had also, the prosecution is going to work with her to modify her bail conditions, and she will be sentenced after the trial, because the trial is set to start at the end of April, which no one thinks it's going to happen at the end of April, but if it does, her sentencing is set for July 10th at 11 a.m., so we'll see if that goes as scheduled. So that will happen after the supposed after the trial is over. Now, I had two reactions to watching Nancy Salzman plead guilty. One, I'm always more sympathetic to someone who owns up to what they have done than to someone who hasn't. And it's hard to look at someone crying and saying they feel sad for what they've done and not feel anything. But I was disappointed that she seemed mostly concerned for herself. The people that she hurt were her family. And she didn't go into so much detail, or even name them, the people that she had hurt, the other NXIVM members, the DOS victims, the victims of the people that she had such aggressively litigated. It just seemed not enough. I know she didn't have to go into a lot of detail, but I would have preferred a little more detail on that aspect of the people that she hurt that weren't related to her. So it came off as, "I'm sad that I got caught. I'm sad about the fact that I have to go to prison. I'm sad that my cash cow is gone. I'm sad that my family relationships are all messed up because of this," but not so much sad for or remorse for what she did. You know, and when she said that NXIVM had done some good, it reminded me of the joke, "The operation was a success, but the patient died." That's how I feel about it. So stay tuned to this channel for more NXIVM news. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you back here next time.